Steak. So many of us show up at the supermarket every single day looking to find the best cut for our budget or our celebration. And quite frankly, it's really, really confusing. So I thought for today, I'd roll out the good old USDA beef chart, and then we'd actually show you some real life examples in the meat case of the types of cuts that you can use when you're looking to make a great steak meal. Now, if you see up here, there's a nice little cartoon that looks like a little cow, and you can see that most of the killer steak cuts come from what I like to call the non-working part of the animal. In the chuck, which is up here in the shoulder, there are actually some great values in steak. Top blade, flat iron, exist side by side in the same primal cut of the animal as some of the low and slow cuts like short ribs, but don't be fooled. They're lower in price, but they still have tremendous flavor and great value. From the rib, well, that's one of the luxury cuts. You've got your standing rib roast, and a lot of people put that as the centerpiece of their holiday meal. But how about grabbing a ribeye steak? That's a real steak lover steak. It's got great inter and intramuscular fat that really, really helps to contribute to that melting flavor of the steak, especially if you're gonna grill it or broil it. Now, from the loin is where a lot of the big time steakhouse cuts come from. The porterhouse, which has a T-bone in the middle of it and has steaks from two different subprimal cuts, the New York sirloin on one side and the tenderloin on the other. The T-bone is from the front half of that primal cut, and so it has a smaller piece of the tenderloin attached to it. A lot of people find tenderloin to be their favorite cut for steak. That's because it has the least amount of connective tissue and the least amount of fat in it. Now, sirloin has, I think, the best value in steak, and one of my favorite steaks to throw on the grill at our house is the tri-tip roast or tri-tip sirloin. And let me tell you something, not expensive at all. In the round, there's not a lot of cuts that I like to choose here for a steak that I'm going to eat just by myself. However, there are some really good things if you want to do a whole roast beef. Get a round tip roast and cook it lower and slower in your oven. The shank and the brisket and other cuts here besides cube steak, which is a tenderized cut of meat that comes from all different parts of the animal. There's really nothing there that's going to please the steak lover. Looking for great steak? Stick in the middle of the animal.